Mount Everest ain't got shit on me. Mount Everest ain't got shit on me. 'Cause I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world. Yeah. March Dubai ain't got shit on me. You can touch the sky, but you ain't got shit on me. 'Cause I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world. Yeah.
And build it up again.
Tell them
I burned it down twice just for the fun of it.
Tell them
so much money I don't know what to do with it.
Tell them
I don't pick up my phone, ain't knowing what to sign.
Tell
them got me one gun and an alibi.
Tell them
so much love that the whole thing feel like a lie.
Coming up next, it's a UFC light heavyweight division collision.
Tickets within 5 minutes of them going on sale, you're gonna be outside.
You're gonna be standing outside, hoping to be inside the arena all the way back to UFC 75 champion versus champion, Rampage versus Dan Henderson. UFC has one fight that is on the roof off O2 Arena.
Well, you saw the tail of the tape, he has a re- Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad, John. He's gotta press him. He's gotta go chase that finish down now.
Try to establish that jab. Oh, big left. They're going at it now.
He's hurt bad.
So holding on to hand with authority, goes for the judo throw right into side control.
He's in side control. He's got a ton of options.
All right, he's sort of hanging out here unguarded, DC. Not sure if he's trying to bait him in or what, but not great body language here. Nice hammer fist.
He's putting him in exactly the position he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
All right, so he postures up. Nicely done. Well, anytime you are in a ground-fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. Man, this is some serious ground and pound. He's trying to put this dude's head, like, through the canvas.
He's one of the better ground and pound fighters you have in the entire UFC, and you're seeing why.
All right, 2 minutes now to go in the round. Oh, so an interesting decision there as he decides to stand up and relinquish the dominant position. Right hook to the head.
Oh, swept the leg beautifully to get the takedown, DC. Mr. Miyagi would be very, very proud of that sweep. Great job getting into your position and finding that beautiful takedown.
Well, he's up, but he is hurting for certain. The finish could come at any time. Oh, man, that couldn't stop good. Flush knee lands to the body by the taller fighter.
His opponent seems to be on his way out of the fight.
So 28 total strikes have now landed for the last style bender, Israel Adesanya. Ooh. And he comes through with a big knee. Now a knee.
horn sounds for the end of round one. All right, so there's the horn signifying the...
You ready to fight? Ready.
Second round underway.
So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. Nice 1-2 there. Oh, beautiful land there by Adesanya. You get this crowd just eating out of his hand, ooing and on every time he... Rocked.
That was a beautiful hook. It landed perfectly, and it hurt his opponent very bad. Digging kick.
Man, look at that damage on the right side of his body. Oh, man, look what that one body shot did.
That shows you the power, and the power in the placement. It was placed perfectly, and now he's got his opponent hurt.
Now goes in and secures the takedown.
All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to... That's a perfect scramble right there. Beautiful transition. All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie, and they separate.
Left hand punch to the clinch.
Oh, he landed a beautiful straight punch there, DC. He's got an edge in reach and certainly is making it count in this one. Oh, nice punch there by Adesanya.
He landed it perfectly.
That's it.
It's over. It's over. What a performance.
Again, the winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught that ultimately appeared as though the outcome was an eventuality. So if you're the referee, you got to protect the fighter. And I thought he did a good job of doing just that. Not every day you see a fight end due to a body kick like that.
He used a lot of body work.
We go inside the octagon to Bruce...
Not a single moment for peace.
Never still. It just keeps rolling down the hill. Nobody tries to stop it. They'll get a copy, get you killed. You'll be a trending topic. A cog up in the wheel. A sacrifice to the cult of death being built.
Caught up in the matrix. Virtual digital minds. We don't memorize phone numbers or directions when we drive. We don't even have to go shopping to get our food and buy things. We only push a button. We don't even have to try.
Can't even lift an eye away from my phone. Talking to Instagram live just so I don't feel alone. Flood of my Twitter feed with my deepest feelings and thoughts. My page is public, but my sense of conversation is blocked. I validate myself through followers just to feel important. Instead of living in the moment, I much rather record it. Nobody knows my first name, but know my Snapchat handle. I'm just a millennial. You'll track the social media standards.
See the pressure
within
and effort. Just
like
the rights of my expression.
Coming up next, it's a UFC light heavyweight division collision. Alright, so here we go with the start of round one. I can tell how excited you are for this matchup. Seems to be a striking advantage on one side, but
this is a big time fight. It feels like a big moment for both of these guys' careers. Who is gonna be able to implement their game plan the best in this matchup between these two big time athletes?
Ho!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Well, you saw the tail of the tape. He has a reach advantage and made good use of it there with that punch. Just out of range with that left hook. All right, he engages in a single collar tie, and they separate.
Good stitch. Oh, he did a great job of rotating him into an underhook.
Oh, man, huge kick to the body. here.
Look at how fast. The only person I can do this to is maybe John. John, there's a weight difference. I don't know if you know jiu-jitsu much. You miss a lot of your classes. If I'm going to do this to anybody, it's Anik.
Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
So just over oh, nice job to the scramble to his feet. Quick entry to get
man,
in on a single.
That was a great single. Oh. He flipped him over the top. What a fantastic takedown.
Welcome to the Cormier Express. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Oh, lands an elbow. Didn't open him up, but very well could have. All right, half-guard position for him here, and I can hear Dominic Cruz in the back of my head just screaming about underhooks somewhere.
Yeah, he loved it. I mean, but he's right, right? He's so right in terms of if you're on your back in the half-guard, one thing you can't be is flat on your back, up on an elbow, and you'll be half on the side, and you need to control the far side underhook. It is a battle for underhook. Take him down, cut him. Take him down, cut him. Over and over, he's securing these takedowns. Now look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent. You got to be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. All right, so good ground and pound by him here. Certainly staying busy, and not just busy, but effective.
You can just throw punches to keep the referee off of you. This guy is throwing punches to be effective, to throw damaging strikes. He's doing a fantastic job.
All right, a lot of high-level striking action in that last round. Daniel. Second round underway.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Oh, he landed a beautiful straight punch there, DC. He's got an edge in reach and certainly is making it count in this one. All right, he closes the distance, gets the single collar tie. Jones's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. The right hand just missed, right to the target. Let's see if his opponent can survive.
I cannot